Hello, and welcome to Module 2 and 261. Before we are able to sort of dive into the low-level details about how computer systems work, we need to make sure we understand how computers represent information and store information. So that's what we're going to be talking about in this module, and today beginning we'll start talking about how computers specifically use binary. So these are the topics that we'll be talking about today: conversions between different bases, data sizes, byte ordering, character and program encodings, and then some bitwise operations. So I want to start us with just a question here. And so I've put some symbols on the screen here on this slide. And so I want you to pause the video and take a minute to think about what do these symbols mean as written on this slide here. If I were to ask you what this means, what would your answer be? And are there multiple answers? So take a moment and see what you think about that. So typically when I do this in class, I get a huge variety of different answers here. And the punchline here is that they're nearly all correct. So sort of the most straightforward meaning here is that if you interpret this as a 100 in base 10, this is 100. But this is not the only way that you could interpret these symbols here. So generally, students suggest binary as an appropriate interpretation here. So if this was a number that was encoded in binary, then this would be a 100, which would be the decimal number 4. You could also do this in hex, in which case this would be, I believe, 256, or you could interpret these as characters, and in which case they might just be IOO. There's a number of different ways that you could interpret this. And this leads to one of the core themes in this class, which is that information is actually bits plus context. So you have to have some bits. You have to have, you know, the symbols stored somewhere. But then you also need bits and their context. You need to know how to interpret those bits, because otherwise there's sort of this, you know, potentially infinite number of ways of interpreting those bits. And so you don't really know what you have until you know the context for what you have. And this is a theme that we will see in many different places this semester. So it's one that's worth thinking about. So it's also worth considering the question of why binary? Why do we use binary in our computers to store information? And the reality is that it's really sort of the simplest form of information. So a bit is either on or it's off, and that's really the fundamental unit of information. And we do this because it minimizes the storage and transmission errors. There's no particular reason aside from that. So, you know, we could have, and there have been computers that have been designed to work with ternary, so three fundamental values. But binary is really the simplest one, and it helps us to, again, minimize errors during storage and transmission. So that's why we use it in computer systems. But what this means is that in order to store more complicated information, we just use more bits. And once we do that, then we need the context in order to understand them. We actually still need context even with one bit, if you think about it. So let's think about storing a Boolean value, right? True or false as one bit. So we actually have two options for this. We could say that, you know, a 0 is on and 1 is off. Or we could say that 0 is off and 1 is on. So even there, with one bit, we still need to know some context about how we're interpreting the information. And then once we expand to more than one bit, that context becomes even more important, because there is the ordering of the bits, and we have to make sure that we're interpreting in the right order and in the right way. And so we're going to learn a lot of different data encodings over the next couple of weeks. These are ways of taking data and encoding them in binary. But of course, first we should be comfortable working with binary, and so that's what we are going to be working on today.